phenomenal foodies on Hot Chocolate Hits. Today I'm going to be interviewing Lindsay Ostrom from the blog Pinch of Yum. If you haven't checked out Pinch of Yum, then what are you waiting for? Go check it out. The link is up here and it's in the description box, and you can click it at the end of the video so you have no excuses. Pinch of Yum is one of my favorite blogs. It has the most amazing recipes, and I'll tell you, Lindsay's photography is awesome. She also has several ebooks, like a photography ebook and a cauliflower ebook that I love as well. So if you want to learn more about how to set up your own food blog and a little bit more about the lady behind the blog, then keep watching. So my first question to you is, like, how has your childhood kind of played a role in your love for cooking?
I think I grew up in a family that really loved food. So even though nobody was really like a fancy cook or, you know, had a lot of like formal cooking experience, we all just loved food, and my parents and siblings, and we would always watch like the Food Network shows, and my mom would always, you know, we'd always have dinner together as a family, even if it wasn't anything fancy or special. We'd always eat together, and I think just like the love of food and interest in food, that's always been something that I've been around, and I think it's been passed off to me just from being around other people that love food so much.
So when you started Pinch of Yum, like there's a ton of food blogs out there, and obviously like yours is one of my favorites. So, but what do you think separates Pinch of Yum from other blogs?
I think right from the beginning, I really tried to be personable with what I was writing about, which is funny because, you know, when you're first starting, it's just really hard to communicate yourself how you want to communicate, like to develop your voice right away. But I just really tried to make a connection with readers and how I was writing, so that, you know, it felt more like a conversation instead of so formal. And then also just trying to be, you know, authentic and real and not trying to pretend to be something. You know, it's not like we're these fancy foodies, but, you know, just being real about who we are and not trying to fit a certain mold. Also, my husband Bjork does like the business side of Pinch of Yum, and we share that a little bit about the business side in our income reports that he writes. And so that's another thing that has, I think, made Pinch of Yum stand out, just because for other bloggers, it's not just a food blog, but it's like can be a teaching resource about how you can grow your blog.
Mm-hmm. You have like a ton of posts about your personal life, and then you have the food and you have the advice. So what is your favorite blog post that you've written?
Well, it was really fun to write the post about going full time with the blog, where that was just a couple months ago, not even a couple months ago, like maybe a month ago. And I just wrote about the decision to leave teaching and how I was going to pursue the blog full time. And it was just fun because it was a personal thing to me, but also my readers were interested in it because it obviously directly relates to the blog. And I don't know, people were super encouraging, and I felt like I was able to clearly kind of communicate like what my goals were with the decision, and also just get a really good engaged response from people. So that was a fun one to write and a fun one to just share, you know, to put out there.
Mm-hmm. And like, you seem really passionate about teaching as well. So do you think that you'll ever return to doing that? Or do you think that you just want to stay full time with blogging? Like,
it's really hard to say because, you know, like when I started the blog, if you would have told me that I would be leaving teaching, I would have said, what, you know, like, that's ridiculous. I'm never going to, you know, food blog, that's so weird. And that was only 5 years ago, for not even 4 years ago. And so I feel like what I've learned is, like, it's you can't know, and it's really hard to know, you know, what you're going to want to do in 2 years or even in, you know, 1 year. And so I think for the time being, like, blogging is where, you know, we're kind of putting all our time and energy is the blog, Food Blogger Pro, our membership site. And when I think about like having a family someday, I think like this kind of a schedule, and the flexibility with the schedule would be a lot more conducive to that. But also I love teaching, and it could be that, you know, the blog just totally flops and we're not able to keep going with it, or we don't want to anymore. And then, you know, obviously teaching is kind of like maybe my first love. And so, I'm definitely not saying no to going back. I think it's a possibility for the future. So,
what are some of the challenges that you face? Like the biggest challenges?
I think a big challenge is always when you're creating something, and for me personally, just like creative roadblocks and coming to a point where you feel like, you can't either you struggle to come up with a new idea, or even more so than that, like you're creating new things, but you don't feel confident in sharing them. And so that's always been a thing for me, and I feel like that's not gonna go away. And maybe I'll just get better at overcoming it. But every time you share something out into the world, you're basically opening it up for people to criticize it or say that they like it, which is great, or they don't like it. And so, having to overcome that and just be okay with putting it out there and knowing some people will like it and some people won't. That's I feel like that's kind of a constant thing, constant struggle with any kind of creative work, but especially with blogging.
And then what are the best parts of blogging besides like the reader connection? Because I know that that's really important.
I think, I mean, like, I'm kind of in this new, I'm it's still like sparkly new for me because, I just 2 weeks ago, like, don't now I don't have to go into work anymore, and I just stay here and just work on the blog. And I think the best part is just like seeing people. I mean, maybe this is kind of what you said with the reader engagement, but it's just like seeing people respond to what you do and have it positively impact their life. So like, I just was going through my emails this morning before we got on the call, and someone had emailed me, and she said, I'm trying to get out of this rut, and I was cooking maybe once a week before, and now your blog makes me want to cook, three or four or five times a week. And so hearing stories like that, what you're putting out there like connects with people, and people not only like it connects with them, but that people like it and they can use it to make their lives better. It's really fun. I really like that. And now that this is my full-time job, it's like that's what I get to work on all the time. So I feel like, just the space is there for me to like continue to create stuff that feels really awesome for people. So I think that's probably the best part.
And you have that Food Blogger Pro, and then you write a ton about like advice for blogging, but what would you say is like the most important thing that people have to remember when they start a blog or when they want to go into this kind of stuff?
I think probably the most important thing is, well, this is, I mean, kind of my thing, but like, you really have to have good photos if you're doing a food blog and you want it to, grow. You really have to pay attention to that. And I think it's easy to think like, oh, the recipes will just, they're good, so people will find them and like them. And it's just so hard. It's so competitive with so many people saying, try this, try this. This is good. Mine is the best. And you really have to, like, the initial hook for people is going to be the image. And so you have to be able to have images that accurately reflect the food and make it look appealing to people so that they will come to your site, try the recipes, and then, have it'll be proved to them that the recipes really are that great. But that initial hook, I think, comes from the images. So really, like, for a new blogger, I would say invest in a good camera or just learn the camera you have. As best as you can, and keep practicing. And I mean, like, just this morning, I was looking at my WordPress, and I've done like almost 600 posts. So you just get better when you've done it that many times. So keep going, keep practicing, and the photography part is really important.
Yeah. So, what, like in the kitchen, since you obviously spend a lot of time there, what's your favorite utensil?
Okay, because I don't know if this is a utensil, but I really, really love the food processor. I use it all the time. And mine is like a really cheap little one. It actually just broke the other day when I was cleaning it, like part of the lid broke off, and I'm still using it because I'm kind of cheap. But I love it because you can really easily make like homemade sauces and things that have good texture, and you just dump it all in and just whir it up, and there it goes. It's delicious. So
Yeah.
that's I really like using the food processor.
And if you were stranded on a deserted island and could only eat one thing, what would it be?
Oh, geez. I would say, oh, does nutri I mean, does it count towards like your lifespan? Like, would the nutrition count for your life? Or
Whatever.
can you
No.
survive?
No,
Can you survive
anything.
no matter what?
Yeah.
I would say, oh gosh, Probably some kind of fruit because it's sweet and I like sweet food, but also there's some nutritional value in it. Maybe like if I had access to like the perfect mango or peaches or something like that, I really like fruits like that.
That's cool. So, your blog is like a partnership between you and your husband. So, is that like your like what do you think of that? Is that do you think that's a good way to go about with a blogger?
Yes and no. I mean, like, it definitely doesn't work for everybody. I think it works for us because our interests, line up naturally and we've kind of made them overlap. Like, I've become a little more interested in the business side because he's interested in it and he's a little more interested in the maybe like a little more interested in the food side because that's what I'm interested in. But it doesn't work for everybody, and it's hard because you—that's your life then. And like, we'll go out, for just out for dinner, and that's what we're talking about. Because normally, in like a couple relationship, you would talk about your jobs, but then both of our jobs are like the same. So, or like at least the same, company, same kind of end goals. So, but it's really fun, and I mean, for us, it works really well. And I would never—I mean, Pinch a Fam would never be what it is today without. Without having Bjork's help in making it into a business and making it into something that could earn an income. So there's definitely, I feel like with a blog, there's so much you could hire 10 people to get all these different skills needed for just one blog, and most people are doing all of that on their own. So I think like even if you don't have a like a significant other or a friend that wants to do any kind of a blog. With you, it is important as you grow to think about building a team. Just one person can't do everything. It's just it's not possible. So I think the team element of it, regardless of whether or not it's your spouse or whatever, it's really important. It's important to have like multiple people helping when possible.
Right.
So.
So you always have like these new projects coming up. Like I bought the cauliflower cookbook and I love it. So what's next for Pinch of Yum? Like what projects do you have coming up?
Well, we have we're actually going to be doing a remodel of our kitchen in our house that we just bought. It's a really small old kitchen, so we're going to knock down the wall and make it a little more open, and then part of the goal with that is to be able to do more video. So actually it was really fun for me to look watch through some of your videos, and I love like watching YouTube cooking videos and just getting some ideas. But with knocking the wall down, we'll just have a more open space where it'll be better for both the photography that I'm doing, and then also it'll allow us a space that just works a little bit better for doing cooking videos. So that's kind of like in the next year where we hope to head. So,
That would be cool to see you
yeah.
to see you more on YouTube because you do have some videos up there
I do
already.
have a few. Yeah, we've just kind of done, we did some like just kind of for fun when we were in the Philippines just to try it out. But yeah, I would love to get like more of a system and have it be really a regular, part of Pinch of Yema. That's a goal that we have. So.
Yeah, so I was talking about your experience in the Philippines, like you a lot of the posts that I've seen from you, like they're somewhat like influenced by that. So would you be open to traveling overseas once again?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we would love to go back to the Philippines, and we're hoping to go back this year. Probably like I don't think we have any plans or at least right now I don't know if we would really seriously think about like moving back where we would, be there for a year or longer. The experience was so wonderful and amazing, and I feel like we learned so much. It was also really challenging anytime you're, out of your comfort zone and away from your support system. There are challenges. So it was really both. I feel like it was both the best time of our life and then also some of the hardest times of our life. So for now, I feel like, we're really thankful for the schedule that we have and the freedom and that, we can just like take a month and go stay somewhere else, live somewhere else. But we also, we bought a house here and we're kind of like putting down small roots here. And so I don't see us like packing up and moving abroad anytime soon. But I think we do have big like aspirations to get to a few, places and kind of like, I don't know, just take advantage of that free schedule, or flexible schedule, I should say, before eventually someday we start family or whatever.
Well, thanks so much. That's all I have for you today.
Yeah, thank you, Medica.
Thanks so much, Lindsay. I really enjoyed getting to know a little bit more about you and your blog, and I'm sure all the viewers did too. Please don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.